So put your hands together, give God a big round of applause for bringing us good. Father and your friend, we thank you today for allowing us to come together as a family of God without names and titles and banners, but just together as children of God to praise and worship your name. We thank you that there is still a fragment in the Trinity community who believes that God reigns.
Amen.
We give you all of the praise and all the glory. Humble your man servant, forgive him where he would have sinned in word, thought, and deed. Make him fit to speak on your behalf. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
And amen. I'd like to share with us this morning on the subject, 2019 is our year.
Amen.
2019 is our year. Tell
amen.
Tell your neighbor, 2019 is our
2019
year.
2019 is our
come
year.
Come on, tell your other neighbor, 2019 is our year.
2019 is our year.
Turn with me to the book of Philippians chapter 3 verses 1 to 14. Philippians chapter 3 verses 1 to 14, and it reads, "Finally, my brethren, rejoice in the Lord. To write the same things to you, to me indeed is not grievous, but for you it is safe. Beware of dogs," verse 2. "Beware of evil workers. Beware of the transition. For we are the circumcision which worship God in the Spirit, and rejoice in Christ Jesus, and have no confidence in the flesh, though I might also have confidence in the flesh. If any other man thinketh that he hath whereof he might trust in the flesh, I must." Verse 5. "Circumcised the 8th day of the stock of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, and Hebrew of Hebrews, as touching the law, a Pharisee, concerning zeal, persecuting the church, touching the righteousness which is in the law, blameless. But what things were gained to me, those I counted loss for Christ. Yea, doubtless, and I count all things but loss for the excellency of the knowledge of Christ Jesus my Lord, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things, and do count them but dung, that I may win Christ." Verse 9. "And be found in him, not having mine own righteousness which is of the law, but that which is through the faith of Christ, the righteousness which is of God by faith. That I may know him, and the power of his resurrection, and the fellowship of his sufferings, being made conformable unto his death. If by any means I might attain unto the resurrection of the dead, not as though I had already attained, either were already perfect, but I follow after, if that I may apprehend that for which I also am apprehended of Jesus Christ." Verse 13. "Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind, and reaching forth unto those things which are before, I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus." 2019 is our year. From the moment God created Adam and Eve and placed them in the Garden of Eden, he gave them both something we call choice. Life has always been about choice and consequence. As we prepare to step into 2019 in less than 48 hours, each Amen. Of us have a choice to dwell on our past hurts and mistakes of yesterday, or focus on our triumphs and prepare and plan for a successful future. I want to challenge the Good Tidings Gospel Hall and those from the Victory Center to prepare for a better future. Prepare for a successful future. 2019 is our year.
Amen.
Nowhere in God's word were we ever promised, Brother Nikhil, that life would be a bed of roses. What we were constantly promised, Sister Annie, over and over and over again, Sister Wallace, was that God is going to be with us all the time, even unto the end of the earth. And he will fight and win our battles, Brother Nikhil. He will fight and win our battles, Sister Annie. He will fight and win our battles, Sister Alyssa. He will fight and win our battles, Brother Dewan. 2019 is our year. Second Chronicles 20 verse 17 says, "Ye shall not need to fight in this battle. Set yourself, stand ye still, and see the salvation the Lord will give to you, O Judah and Jerusalem. Fear not, nor be dismayed. Tomorrow go out against them, for the Lord will be with you." As we prepare to step into 2019, let us claim this as our year, our year, our year. Words have power. 2019 is our year. Our
Amen.
Year of success, our year to rise, our year to evangelize, our year for better. 2019 is our year.
Amen.
Firstly, I want to remind us that it is imperative that we stay positive and stay rejoicing. Stay positive and stay rejoicing. In Philippians chapter 3 and verse 1, it says, "Finally, my brethren, rejoice in the Lord. To write these things, same things to you, to me indeed, is not grievous, but for you it is safe." It was the Apostle Paul who had turned his life around thanks to God's intervention, who was writing to the church at Philippi here, Brother Martin. Yeah. It was the Apostle Paul, someone who had been through it all. Yeah. He understood how dirty people could be, Brother Evelyn, when he wrote Philippians 3 verse 2, Brother Cotton. He said, "Beware of the dogs. Beware of the evil workers. Beware of the transitions." I want you to know, brothers and sisters here, and listening all across the world, that everybody in the world doesn't like you. Everybody in the world does not appreciate you. Everybody in St. Kitts and Nevis and around the Caribbean and world don't want to see you succeed. That is why the Apostle Paul, a seasoned man in the God now, he had changed from following the devil and persecuting Christians. So he knew how dirty people could be because he was not himself.
Yes, sir.
He said, "Beware, be careful with the dog, be careful with the evil people." That is why I want to encourage us young people especially, from small, be careful with your association. Be careful with your association. You saw it right before you in a true life movie this morning. The young man stopped going to church, stopped listening to his father and mother. He went to party his life away, and God got his attention. It's sad that sometimes God has to knock us down to get our attention. Don't let it come to that. While you're here in church, stay in church, stay in your meeting, stay in Bible study, stay around the things of God, because the world has nothing to offer. I say that, but life has always been about choice and consequence. If you don't stay here, and you want to go out and taste the world and get hurt and burn like the brother in the movie today, God forbid, but so let it be. Choice. Life is about choice and consequence. If you want 2019 to be your year, if you want 2020 to be your year, if you want 2021 and 2022, and onwards, God, if God lives, saves our soul. Stay with God.
Amen.
Stay with God. Living for God isn't boring. If you follow Brother Christmas, I have one of the most exciting lives in all this place as a child of God. But just know your limits. Stay positive, stay rejoicing. Today, the 30th day of December 2018, will never come again. Tomorrow will be the 31st day of December 2018 and will never come again. And a couple of hours after that, we'll be here again, welcoming in 2019, once God's will. We become what we think. If you think negative, talk negative, and associate with negative people, you will always be miserable, disgruntled, and depressed. If you think positive, on the contrary, think positive thoughts, associate with positive people, read and watch and listen positive material, you will always be optimistic that better is ahead. Even though at times you will be pushed down and crushed down, because you have a positive mindset, one day you will rise again. 2019 is our year to rise, Brother Nikhil. 2019 is our year to rise, Sister Annie. You don't let anybody stop you. Watch your association. No bother with people talking negative. Associate with positive people. Associate with people who can lift your spirit. Associate with people chatting good things on your WhatsApp, man. Come on. Stay positive, stay rejoicing. The Apostle Paul, thousands of years, wrote that, Brother Martin. "Finally, my brethren, rejoice in the Lord." Life has always been about choice and consequence. You go down behind the band, ba ba da ba da ba ba ba, push back, push back, ba ba da ba ba da ba ba da ba, push back. What do you get out of that? What do you get
he says he will do.
When you hear somebody say, thanks, thanks, I give you thanks. When you hear another singer say, to God be the glory.
The things he has done.
Those things, put some. Help us, Lord. Those are songs that inject some hope into your spirit. That better is ahead. Watch your association.
Amen.
Life is about choice and consequence. Make your choice and face the consequences. Point two. Don't trust the flesh. Don't trust the flesh. Let the Holy Spirit lead and guide you. Don't trust the flesh. Let the Holy Spirit lead and guide you. The Apostle Paul wrote in Philippians 3 verse 7, but what things were gained to me, those I counted loss for Christ. I want to challenge us young people and older ones alike, as we prepare to step into 2019, Sister Avenues. Drop the things that are stifling your personal relationship and all with the Almighty God. Yeah. Let us examine our individual and collective lives, Sister Walters. And drop the things that are not encouraging us to live a life that pleases God. Don't trust your flesh. Whatever is causing you to forget God, forget church, forget praying, forget reading your Bible, drop them. Is it your boyfriend? Your girlfriend? Or are they interested in telling you, baby, 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 you look so nice. And all the girl is interested in asking you, brother, I want some weave. I want a perfume. I want some money. And nothing about God. Drop them. If you have a boyfriend and a girlfriend, and I like to be frank, because you have age, nothing is wrong with having a boyfriend and a girlfriend. That is healthy. But you have to watch and learn this pattern of yours. Nothing about God that will send you on the WhatsApp. When the talk is only sexual talk, they're talking on the phone. These are things that are stifling your relationship with God. I want to challenge us young people. If we are to rise in 2019 and onwards, we have to remember, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all of the things shall be added.
Amen.
Examine your boyfriend. Examine your girlfriend for 2019.
And hallelujah.
If they're the type of boyfriend and girlfriend that God wants in your life, don't carry them over into 2019.
Amen.
Drop them. If you have a husband or a wife and they're serious about God, I can't tell you, drop them. But get down and miss it. Start getting in some serious prayer and fasting for your husband or your wife. If all the thing they want to watch is soaps, and all the thing they want to watch is the movie, pray for them. Get some counseling. Hold them to come to church with you. Invite them to Bible study. Don't give up on your relationship like that, man. Get them involved in the things of God. 2019 is our year, but it cannot be our year if we do not put God first. What else is hindering you from moving onward and forward? If 2019 is to be our year, we can't watch so much of Parliament Reform anymore. If 2019 is to be our year, we can't watch so much of porn on our tablets anymore when mommy and daddy ain't watching. If 2019 is to be our year, we can't spend all our time gossiping with our friends on our phone and on WhatsApp and on the street corner and the job, because fruitless gossip gets you nowhere. Don't come tell me anything about Sister Alyssa and what she do here and there, unless you want me to talk to her and help her. Don't come tell me she business. If you don't want me to approach her and offer a word of advice, not to condemn her but help her, don't come tell me she business. Don't come tell me Brother Liban and Brother Martin and Brother Evelyn business. If you don't want us to approach them as men and women of God, that's how I operate. I ain't want nobody business like that. Fruitless gossip gets you somewhere. But come and tell me about the sister who has been through a trial in her alive and she wants a bag of food, and we could put together and carry a bag of food for the sister. Tell me about that.
Yeah.
I want to hear that he said, she said, them say and all kind of things, and when they're done, you find out the truth ain't true. Stop spreading those kind of rumors. Foolishness doesn't get you nowhere. Drop those things that are keeping you from developing your relationship with God. If 2019 is to be your year, you have to change how you operate. If 2019 is you will be your year, you can't run and live a promiscuous sex life anymore. Let us be different in 2019. You cannot claim 2019 as your year if you hold on to the rubbish and the dung. Do like the Apostle Paul said in verse 7, but what things were gained to me, those I counted lost for Christ. The Apostle Paul determined in his spirit, since I decided to change my walk with the devil, I have to drop those things for the sake of Christ. Examine your life as we are at the end of 2018. Don't step over into 2019 with some of the rubbish and dung that has been keeping you down and back in life. New York, listening in Africa, listening in Jamaica, drop those names and go forward with God for 2019. Yes. Paul was a Christian persecutor until God got his attention on the road to Damascus.
Yes.
Be careful if God has intervened and get your attention in a radical way. Be careful! We looked at the movie. He wouldn't listen to his daddy. God intervened and got his attention. Notice what happened. When the young man in the movie came to his senses, when the fellows were probably going to beat him up and kill him, he ran. He didn't run to another bar. He didn't run to hide on that boat. He ran to somebody's house and noticed where he called in a brother Evelyn. He ain't called none of his girlfriends from before in a brother Cotton. He begged, he knocked on the door. He wanted to call real home. He wanted to call home. When you get a cut on your foot, you ain't running by your neighbor, you know. Mommy, mommy, I get a cut. He said, mommy or your daddy, you want it. So he just saw me, man. Little puppies from a dog, yeah, if they get in trouble, they're running back to their mother. The foul is so they made. It's so we made too. He runs and he gets a call home. And even though he didn't listen to his mother and his father, his daddy still got up at 4 o'clock to go and look for him. What a God we serve, eh? A God that causes rain to fall on the just and the unjust. A God that causes the sunshine to shine on those who jamming in the bands and those who decide to come to church. Choice and consequence. Don't let God have to get your attention in a radical way. Trust him before it is too late. 2019 is your year.
Amen.
I challenge us today, as we prepare to step over into 2019, to consider our ways. Don't walk into 2019 the same as you were in 2018 and 2017 and the years before. Now is the time to let God lead your life. Now is the time, as Christians, as God follows, whatever you call yourself listening around the world, to humble to God and let the Holy Spirit start leading and guiding. You've been trying to run your life for far too long. You were once a child of God and you ran away. You've been a fugitive from God for far too long. Consider your ways. Point 3, and finally, dare to change your thinking. 2019 is our year. Focus. Dare to change your thinking. 2019 is our year. Focus. Verse 13 and 14 says, brethren, I come not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind me, and reaching forth unto those things which are before, I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Stop looking behind, Sister Dana. Stop looking behind, Sister Alyssa. Stop looking behind, Sister Annie. Stop looking behind, Sister Wallace. Stop looking behind, Brother Cotton, Brother Martin. Not one of us can say we never made a mistake in life. All of us have made mistakes in life. All of us have made wrong choices in life. All of us have said things we should not have said. All of us did things we should not have done. None of us can undo our life mistakes for the evening. We are flesh and blood. We are human. We sin in word, thought, and deed, but for the grace of God. King David made some mistakes. King Solomon made mistakes. Adam and Eve made the first big mistake. King Nebuchadnezzar made a mistake with the three Hebrew boys. He threw them in the fire until God got his attention. And I can go on and on. Stop dwelling on your past. Focus on the future. Focus on 2019 and 2020 and 2021. Develop a plan. A map for your future, Sister Diane. You can build a strong house without, you can't build a strong house without a proper plan, Brother Cotton. So to you, Brother Lemons and Brother Darren, you have to plan now in your mind that you will change your thinking, Sister Vaughn. Nothing in life comes easily, Sister Sharon. You have to work hard, Sister Clarice. You have to stay positive and fighting in life. And for those, if I didn't call your name, I have to get more familiarized with your name. Forgive me. But I love you still. Fight on. Fight on, not with swords and guns. Not with knives and bottles and stones like you see them doing through the morning. Fight on your knees. Pray more. Study your Bible more. Associate with godly people more. James 5:16 says, confess your faults one to another. And pray one for another that ye may be healed. The effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. Press, 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 press Good Tidings Gospel Hall, press Victory Center, press Global Listeners, press into your destiny with God, with God, with God, with God. All things are possible. 2019 is our year.
Amen.
I press, says the Apostle Paul, toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Work on your spiritual life in 2019. Read your Bible more. Study your Bible more. Pray more. Attend church, Bible study, men and women's meeting and youth fellowship more. Only what is done for Jesus Christ will last unto your feet. Work on your life. Get your act together. Here if we work on us. Work on you. Develop you. Make a plan. Make several plans. Have a dream. Have several dreams. You cannot win the prize if you don't have a dream. 2019 is our year. Once we put God first, stand to your feet. You can start to figure it out. God bless you. Listen to all the world.